California.
Madam Speaker, at this time I'm very privileged to yield 3 minutes to the distinguished former chairman of the Republican Conference, my friend from Columbus, Indiana, Mr. Pence.
Gentleman from Indiana is recognized for 3 minutes.
I thank the gentleman for yielding, and I would ask unanimous consent to revise and extend my remarks.
Without objection.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I rise in support of the rule, but I rise from my heart with a deep sense of gratitude to the American people to urge my colleagues in both parties to join us as we keep our promise to the American people and next week vote to repeal their government takeover of health care lock, stock, and barrel. I know Democrats said at the time that they had made history. I said at the time, I thought we broke with history. We broke with some of our finest traditions, limited government, personal responsibility, and most profoundly, the consent of the governed. On a late Sunday night in March, the last majority had their say. On a Tuesday in November, the American people had their say. And that brings us to this moment. It is remarkable, though, to hear members of the minority explaining their opposition to this bill. Only in Washington, D.C., a year ago, only in Washington, D.C., could you say you were going to spend trillions of dollars and save people money. And this morning, only in Washington, D.C., could you say that repealing a $2.7 trillion government takeover of health care is actually going to cost money. I'd be pleased to yield.
Speaker, I thank my friend for yielding. I wondered if he might repeat that line. I think he said that only in Washington, D.C. can there be an interpretation that cutting $2.7 trillion in spending is actually going to end up costing the American people. Is that what the gentleman was saying? I thank my friend for yielding.
I thank the gentleman. I reclaim my time. Yes. It must be mystifying for people looking in this morning to hear about the most expensive one-page bill in American history. I say again, only in Washington, D.C. could a Congress vote to repeal a $2.7 trillion government takeover of health care, and a minority says it costs the American people money. Now, I know they don't like us to call it that, but let me explain. When you mandate that every American buy government-approved insurance, whether they want it or need it or not, when you create a government-run plan paid for with job-killing tax increases, when you provide public funding for abortion for the first time in American history, that's a government takeover of health care that violates the principles, the ideals, and the values of millions of Americans, and the American people know it. Now look, after we repeal Obamacare next week, we can start over with common-sense reforms that will focus on lowering the cost of health insurance without growing the size of government. Republicans will waste no time in bringing greater freedoms to the American people to purchase health insurance the way they buy life insurance, the way they buy car insurance. We'll deal with responsible litigation reform. We'll even use the savings to cover pre-existing conditions. I urge my colleagues to join me in support of this rule, but join us as we keep our promise to the American people and repeal their government takeover of health care once and for all.
Gentlemen's time's expired. Gentlelady from New York.
Madam Speaker, this is not a dispute.